This is for you, for those living and those yet to live. And it is about living and the difference between life and survival. Underground, we survive more than we live. Just enough air for breathing. Just enough light for reading. And what we cannot see with our own eyes, we look for in newspapers. Revolution, threat and counter-threat. History comes to us piece by piece, morning by morning. Atomic age, Cold War, balance of terror. Can we accept the fact that this is a battleground, that we are the soldiers, we are the targets? Survival used to be a word for tales of people lost on the desert or stranded in a lifeboat. Now survival is a matter for lunch hour tours. What news could we hear? For what could we pray? For what could we live? We call another people atheistic materialists, and yet we produce more for the man who has everything than for the child who has nothing. We debate what to do with surplus foods. We send machine guns as foreign aid. What can they think? We, they, men seeing men as ink on paper, as pawns on a chessboard. The game is out of war. So is whatever heroism or valor there once was. Crosshairs are aligned on radar blips. Buttons are pushed from underground centers. Such mechanisms require mechanical men. Memories of some wars are still alive, but these children will have no memory of another war. They grow up playing war, seeing it played. Can they know the difference between a cap pistol and a cannon? In the blindness of fear, we are invading our own streets. We are contaminating our own sky. And we are setting 1,000 fuses to the earth. How long can we prepare destruction in the name of protection? How long must we play devils against angels? When will we begin to see our own image? The Easter cross is sold in chocolate form. The weapons of death are displayed in public parks. What kind of people are moved to stand on street corners, to hold banners before tanks and rockets? Cranks and crackpots? Idealists and do-gooders? Sometimes, but sometimes not. Men trying to find a way to live as men. Women trying to find a future for their children. People who read the same headlines but ask new questions. Who can be defended by hair trigger missiles? Who would limit a limited war? What deterrent is likely to deter an accident? Which way is sanity? Which way is disaster? Who is the enemy? Where is the war? The war is here. The enemy is fear. many people can be killed in one day? Experts disagree. Some say 50 million. Some say 500 million. Destruction of cities has not begun, but the seeds of growing things are already affected. Milk, teeth, bones, genes. There are no mad scientists to blame. The madness is in using science and education as weapons. Are we surrendering freedom in the name of its defense? Are we already in our shelters, already underground? Even the smallest freedoms are being neglected. A letter to your congressman or newspaper, the right to join with those working for peace, make voices heard together, to communicate ideas that never reach the headlines. Memos to write, pamphlets to read. How much can they carry the reality of life and death? Minds cannot contain all of a dilemma. It is expressed through bodies as well. Sometimes in nervous energy, sometimes in violence. These people have chosen to walk. They are Quakers, and 1,000 of them have gathered in Washington to stand in silence for 2 days before the Pentagon. They say this is not a picket, not even a protest, but a vigil at the heart of a sickness. Gandhi said, "Those who say that religion has nothing to do with politics do not know what religion means." There are many ways to take a stand. Some public, some private. Some from reason, some from faith. If we are numb to the language of words, we must speak in the language of faces. Thank you. We have been trying to live without pain, and so we have begun to exist without feeling. And we have forgotten the most simple truth, that darkness is the reason for light, that out of hate we can find love, out of anguish we can hope, out of silence we can speak.